This is White Dove again, getting ready to show you guys what it is in QuickBooks Online that you need to usually start with. So we have the process down. That is where we run the receipt bank, we run the QuickBooks Online, we get everything going. But this is directly related to just the QuickBooks Online file. What we're going to do inside of this one is show you where you need to be on a regular basis. And this is not for anything but basically your bank feeds and what needs to be done, how it needs to be done each week inside that 15 to 30 minute window that you put eyes on your financial picture inside your business. So when you come into your QuickBooks Online, your first screen is the dashboard. This is the most familiar screen you're going to have. Inside of there, you can go over here to connect one of your bank accounts, or you can connect to your bank accounts under banking. Inside of banking, this is your main screen. This is where you're going to look at what transactions you have going out or coming in every single week during that 15-30 minute window. This is where when you have items that are already locked in and already existing in the register, they will have a record found. When they don't have something existing in the register, they're going to come in as an item over here. And this area that's in black does not mean that that is where it needs to go. That means QuickBooks Online is not sure where to put that for you. So it's just giving it a good guess. This is, if it's green, if this area is green, then it's actually where you put that last time. Otherwise, if it's black, it's just shooting in the dark as to where to put it. When you come in here, let's go ahead and handle your matches first. Anything that has a record found, a match, anything, any of those items, you can go ahead and take those first. Take the easy ones, cherry pick the low-hanging fruit on this, then jump into your duplicated ones. And when you come in here, you'll see it says check debit, cash purchase. You want to find the one that actually associates with the date. We know this is the right one. So we're going to go ahead and match it to that one. And it'll give you two examples of possibilities because they both are around the same date and they both are for the same amount. So you need to double down on those ones and make sure they go to the right direction. Take the rest of these items and match them through. Get rid of all the ones that you know for sure, and that'll leave you the items that you are not certain of. And once we get to that point, then this is what makes it easy for the virtual office hours, because if there are items that come through and you don't know what to do with them, the virtual office hours are a perfect example of how we can drill down and fix that for you, get it where it needs to go, create a new category for you, make sure the category is set up properly. All the above. That is really what the virtual office hours is good at helping you with, and that is your chance to jump in and be able to work with me directly at that moment to get the answers that you need immediately. That's going to be your quickest opportunity. Otherwise, you will be doing through Slack. Then you can go ahead and give me that information through Slack. Next thing that you're going to need is, if you're running invoices, you want to make sure that you're staying on top of your invoice section. And in your invoice section, if you have items that are being deposited, you want them to go to, let's go up and run a deposit. Actually, let's take this receipt right here. We're going to receive payment. And you want this to go to undeposited funds every single time. Please do not change it to your checking account or a banking institution that you have in your QuickBooks Online. There is a reason for the undeposited funds, and I want you to start learning how to use that, because if anything gets funny, then I can walk you through how best to renegotiate that and navigate away from that, how it's going wrong. But if it's not to undeposited funds, you end up having these direct line incomes going straight to your bank account. And then when you have a batch deposit come in, it creates an issue inside the bank account because it doesn't know what to tie it to. So this way, if you're reusing invoices, you want to clear the invoice out. You want to be able to match it to an income transaction inside the bank feed, and you want to be able to have it go all the way through. This is the holding place. Undeposited funds is critical. It is the holding place. Outside of that, your expenses are all covered inside of your QuickBooks bank feed inside of here. This is where your accounts are actually handled for your income, or I'm sorry, your expense categories. This area is where you will have all of those taken care of because we want to utilize it here. We want to actually make those adjustments and corrections inside the bank feed because it's a lot easier than having to drill down inside of, you know, transactions, finding them, figuring out where they are. They will surface. If there's an issue, it will surface around the reconciliation, but let's get in the habit of doing it right from the bank feed going forward. That's all I'm going to put into this, where to start with your QuickBooks Online. Those are the two main items that most people are at. If you need to see, let me go one more thing. If you need to see your chart of accounts, and we will touch on this in one of the deeper modules of how to establish a chart of accounts, it will already be pre-filled for you, but this is an ever-evolving area in your business. It will grow on your expenses and we'll split it out on your income and do some really cool things with it down the road once you kind of get your feet in the water a little bit and you're able to move forward with some ease. After that, just go ahead each week and handle the bank feeds and then come to the virtual office hours with your questions. I hope that's helpful and I will talk to you soon. Bye-bye.